In 2007, council deemed the town hall to be earthquake prone. This is because it is built on uncompacted reclamation, it's also got very shallow piles, and it's also an unreinforced brick masonry building. Council wanted to base isolate the building, and the reasons for doing this was it gives us the greatest level of protection for people in the building. Also, it gave us the greatest level of protection for the heritage of the building, meaning that we would do most of the work below ground and retain much of the heritage of the building above the isolation plane. So this image shows the isolators in location and the structure below the isolators. So we've cut away the building and we can clearly see the locations of the isolators and how they relate to the piles and the pile caps that are placed below them. So this is a scale model of a base isolator. It's made of a mixture of lead, rubber and metal. The metal and rubber are glued together with a centre core of lead. This enables the isolator to move in an earthquake when the horizontal acceleration occurs, putting less stress on the building above it. So as part of the project, what we've done is we've undertaken a 3D scanning of both the interior and the exterior of the building. This gives us the best snapshot of the current structure that we can get. This has enabled us to be quite specific about our design, where we've put the isolators. It helps us also to completely understand the heritage fabric of the building. As Wakefield Street is lower, we'll be putting the isolation plane in above ground on this side of the building. Now, the isolation plane will go in at approximately this level here. Once we've finished, you won't see where this line is. So here we are under the Civic Square. Now, this is on the north side of the building. Here we'll be putting the isolation plane in underground, and approximately this line through here. Here in the auditorium, where we're currently taking out the organ, we'll be carefully lifting the mattai floor, coming in with our piling rigs, piling, putting in the isolators, and then relaying the floor again. So in essence, when we're finished, you won't notice the difference. So I'm here with Hamish McKenzie, who's our lead engineer on the project. Hamish, what do you see as being the key challenges for the project?
So the building's a very historic building. It's made from very brittle materials. And so that gives us challenges in terms of the options we've got to strengthen it, and has led us towards base isolating the building. The other main challenge is the foundation. So the building sits on reclamation fill, which is prone to liquefaction, and it means we need to refound the building. We're installing a number of reinforced concrete piles that go down through the reclamation fill that will give the building a very robust foundation.
What do you find the most interesting part about this project?
So I find it interesting that this building's responded to the earthquake issue over a number of years. For example, after the Napier earthquake in the 1930s, the clock tower and parapets were removed to reduce that risk. So a lot of the easy work has been done on this building over the years, and this is an opportunity to once and for all deal with the seismic status of the building in its entirety, to protect it for future generations.
So that's a quick overview of the project. At the end, the town hall will be stronger and safer. For more information, visit our website.